In order to understand the necessity of neuromuscular re-education, as well as assess potential muscular conditions, I would like to refer you to these pictures. On the first picture, we can see muscles in the normal resting tone. The physical manifestation of the normal resting tone are the absence of discomfort, tension or restriction of motion, and the absence of having urge to massage this particular muscle. On the second picture, we can see a muscle with a high resting tone. As you can see, the same muscle is shortened and widened. In this case, the person can experience a little discomfort. At the same time, we can expect that the muscle will demonstrate some degree of insufficiency during stabilization and movement action. This high resting tone of muscle can result from physical and/or emotional overload. Irritation of spinal nerves can also initiate the reflectoric higher tone. This insignificant higher muscle tone has to be addressed. Otherwise, muscles will gradually accumulate tension to the point that microcirculation will be disturbed and paralyzing system will be activated. Consequently, the person will start experiencing pain and limitation of range of motion, along with many more dysfunctional attributes. In such case, we can say that this particular muscle will demonstrate insufficiency in movement and stabilization of region, which in turn will contribute significantly to the instability of the joint. Additionally to the functional insufficiency that these muscles would sustain, if this painful stage of muscular abnormalities would not be timely addressed, the muscle could develop a hypertone condition with the pathological changes within the muscles. Usually, the higher resting tone of muscles should be addressed by receiving massage or by constant warm-up routine. In picture number 3, we can see difficult muscular pathology. As we know, muscle mass is composed by muscular fibers. In this case, partial fibers of the same muscles accumulate much more tension than other part of the same muscle, which make this part of the muscle shorter than the rest of the fibers of the same muscle. Any attempt that will cause muscle to participate in movement or stabilization will also cause the overtense part of muscles to be disproportionately overworked. In this case, massage alone or regular stretching will not help. If this difficult pathology will not be adequately addressed, it is very possible that a person will suffer a significant muscular tear. As a matter of fact, the constant overwork of this part of the muscle will lead little by little to the partial microscopic muscle fiber tears, to the point that one day the most insignificant movement can cause a massive partial or complete tear. In this condition, not only will stretching not be helpful, but to some degree it can aggravate the abnormality. At the time of maximum stretching, Golgi organ that located in the tendon fires electrical impulse that cause muscular relaxation. With this pathological change in the muscle, this impulse will bring relaxation to an unstressed part of the muscles and will not affect the pathological changed part. The cure will come in the form of the post-isometric relaxation techniques. In order to explain what the post-isometric relaxation techniques are, we first have to discuss types of muscular actions. The muscular actions are divided in several types: isotonic, isometric, and other actions. Isotonic action is such when muscles contract with no extra load, gradually shortening and transmitting the power to sustain the movement. Isometric action is such when muscles attempt to contract, but because it's countered with the equal force in opposite direction, it cannot produce any movement. As a result, the whole muscle mass is forced to stretch in order to fight this resistance. At a time of isotonic movement, the shorter over-tensed part of the muscle will work, but the loose part of the muscle will not. This regime will significantly overload the pathologically changed part of the muscle. In order to eliminate the pathological changes within muscle, we must apply isometric action and post-isometric relaxation techniques. The isometric action will stretch the pathologically shortened part of the muscle, just like it will stretch the rest of the muscle. After, pathological part of the muscle will be stretched for 30 seconds. Now all the muscle fibers will be stretched equally. At this time, we need to apply post-isometric stretching techniques, which will cause Golgi-Oren to fire impulse, thus making all the muscle equally relaxed. Right now, we kind of mobilize with post-isometric relaxation, which include neuromuscular re-education, you understand, but most important, the balance, the muscles, and especially paravertebral muscles. And right now, the erectors of lumbar spine, just like this, we're holding and resisting. And you see this movement, what I'm doing, I'm creating, I hope camera will show, I just pushing against this bed sheet, I'm pushing and I create isometric tension in paravertebral muscles. Yeah, after 30 seconds, I just hold like this, inhale, and exhale. Absolutely passive stretching. And again, inhale, and exhale. Now we will little bit flex more and like you're pushing away, but of course the direction have to be like this. And relax, inhale, and exhale. And hold for 10-15 seconds, and again, under stretch. Allow to Golgi organs to release this impulse. Inhale, and exhale.